everybody. I'm doing a pour today on a 11 by 14 canvas. I had done a video the other day and yesterday, and the video kind of got a little messed up. So I don't know if I'll be posting that one. So I figured since I had some leftover paint from that, I would do another one. A little bit, maybe same technique. I'm going to do a swipe, I think, but I'm going to use this pretty bronze as my swipe color. It's from Deco Art Metallics, and it's bronze. And then the other colors that I'm using are from the Fine Touch, and I've got Ultra Blue, Phthalo Blue, and Teal. And then my white and black, I may put a little black. I do have some extra white. And those are Artist Loft Flow Acrylic. And those are what I keep in my bottles. Now, the colors in my cups all have alcohol. 91% isopropyl alcohol is what I use. All colors, swipe color included. But the colors in my bottle don't, because I don't do that. So if I have to use those won't have any. But the rest do. So I'm going to start with, let me move this back a little bit so it's... You're able to see, I've got all my sticks here. Move this back just a touch. There we go. So I'm going to start with the bronze. And I'm going to put that right in the middle. And I find that I have a tendency of putting too much of my swipe color in the middle, at least for me. And then it tends to take over. Or I'm not swiping hard enough. Not really sure, but that's all I'm putting in there. And then I still have some left over. Oh well. So now I'm just going to kind of swirl it all over. Not in any particular fashion. Just kind of all over. I'll just fill in spots. And I'll put some white in here. I don't know if you can hear all that squeaking, but I have all those solar guys in my window behind me, and they're quite noisy. I didn't realize how noisy they were. Sure which one's the culprit, because there's quite a few back there. But I think I may have found him. You can still hear clicking, but at least not squeaking, because that can be a little annoying. Just saying. No one likes annoying. Oh, there's a lump of something just fell in there. Yeah, he's a hard... Probably when I stirred my paint up again from the sides. And where did I put my black? There it is. I'm gonna put a little bit right in here. Okay. Oh, I have a lot of this blue on here, on this side anyway. No, I think I'm just gonna tilt it just a little. Okay, so now, oops, I'll try to fill this in a little. I don't wanna, yeah, I'll just use this white and just fill that in. That way the sides will be covered just in case. Oops, I touched it. Okay, I'm not gonna put that one on there yet. Okay, so now I am going to get my papers. I got all these lovely papers in the mail. Some junk mail. It's actually working out. All these advertisements for flowers. So, I'm just going to use these. And then I'm going to swipe from the middle. I'm going to do smaller swipes. Let it touch a little. It's not, not touching the end. Make sure your papers are even, because that's what happens sometimes. If your paper is not completely flat, it will, you know, it lifts up in spots. I mean, they can always be fixed, I suppose, but there, drag that through. I think I'm gonna cut these in half real quick and then just use a smaller piece because then I can get more out of it. There we go. What you can do too is I use this little palette knife. Okay. Okay, and now I'll drag it down. One little empty spot. I never saw that. Rip those up real quick. That one's got a piece on the end. Sometimes if you do this, it'll put a little extra color on the side. It helps a little bit. Alright. That looks really pretty. Just gonna go just over the sides a bit. Actually, I think I'm going to get my torch out real quick. Okay. really get a lot of, there's some air bubbles popping, but not a lot of cells. Little stuffs. And that's all right. Sometimes it looks good without. Actually, I'm not going to do anything yet. I'm just going to tilt a little bit. Tilt. Yep.